All right, everybody say it with me. Sue. All right, now we're going to say there's something special about this community, and I can't seem to put my finger on it. Hunter Withrow, thank you so much for becoming my third patron. You are what keeps the dream alive. And now, we head over to the Reddit. The first one says, non-usable weapons? Considering you would have a hard time finding SWAT teams in the West using AK-47s and Tech 9s, high-point carbines and other guns, police wouldn't use but rather on suspects of SWAT raids, will there be guns like the aforementioned only usable by the suspects, or will we be able to use everything they can? And the developer replies with, NPC suspects use a bunch of weapons that the SWAT can't use. Alright, let's move on. The next one says, how are you guys balancing the reaction times between officers and suspects? Are the officers generally faster than the suspects, or are they toe-to-toe? So for instance, constantly giving open and clear command may not be a good idea, and it's best to make good use of your flashbangs and other grenades strategically. And the developer replies with, suspects regularly have an advantage of position. SWAT are pretty lethal, but we're still tweaking it, and we'll continue to. So unfortunately, I don't have a definitive answer to this one yet. We'll probably pick whatever feels best in the player's hands. A huge aspect of this sort of design comes down to level design as well, where it becomes less about the brevity of the engagement and more about your positioning and where you choose to send your officers, like chess. Huh. That's actually pretty interesting. Alright, moving on. The next one says, for voice acting, could you get some generic voice lines not related to place or plot to make it easy for modding? In SWAT 4, especially for the dispatch, they say the name of some places and some suspects have lines related to their original missions that they were placed in. For modding, that could be awkward if they make a map in some different area and dispatch says another, or the suspect says something not related to the place or mission. An example of this is in my Arma 3 SWAT mission, that some suspects and dispatch say things not related to the place and mission, and the developer replies with, SWAT 4 didn't let you add new sounds in game as a part of maps without changing the whole game sounds configuration. Ready or not will. So you won't need to reuse content like maps do in SWAT 4. It's the same situation with AI types. Huh, interesting. Curious to see what the modern community comes up with. Let's move on. The next one says, what's it like developing RON on UE4? Would it be easier on Unity 3D? Is it hard? Would you recommend it if someone wanted to make a similar game to RON? And the developer replies with, it's kind of tricky to compare whether Unity is easier or harder to use compared to Unreal, as some of our team, myself included, have not used Unity. I can personally recommend Unreal as it's a very powerful platform with plus 20 years of tech behind it from a developer who makes games, and not just engines, so they understand the score better in my opinion. Somebody replies to that saying, how long does it typically take to learn how to use a game engine? And the developer replies with, it depends a lot on your prior experience with other game engines. If it's your first game engine that you've worked on with, it's going to be much harder to learn about its workings than your third or fourth. Moving on, the next one says, friendly fire? Just gonna blitz through some questions, speculate at will. Will Ready or Not feature friendly fire? How will other players interact with other members on their team? I.e., will bullets from the other player fly through them or hit them without doing any damage? Just curious. Sorry if this has been asked before. Have a wonderful day. So yes, this has been answered on the FAQ, and as you can tell, there's not a whole lot of people that read it, so it's like, I feel like one day I should make a video about it, but that's a long fucking document, and it doesn't get updated all the time. Yeah, the last time it was updated was like 20 days ago. And the developer replies with, yeah, there's friendly fire. Alright, moving on. The next one says, does the length of a breach affect the positioning of anyone inside, i.e. the longer the breach, the more ready they will be? And then there's a video that's attached where they literally are just banging on a door for a whole 10 goddamn minutes, actually 13 minutes to be exact, and they're just literally banging on the door. I had to check to see if this was a GIF or not, but no, they just keep banging on the door for the entire 10 minutes until they decide to bring a crowbar in. Man, that's one sturdy door. Down in the comments, somebody says, I would like to ask a serious question. Will there be situations like this, where the door is seemingly blocked, and it takes a long time and nearly impossible to breach, so you'd be forced to find another way to the room or area, or you just keep ramming the door for 10 minutes with no result, or try C2 charges to see if the door can even be opened? I hope the question is is clear. I have once again had a few beers. Nice rhyme. And the developer replies with, doors have an integrity option we can control when designing a level. So if there's a door that we don't want people to easily cruise through, we can just up the integrity so it takes a few attempts to break through. That's pretty cool, actually. That like makes the levels even more interesting. If all the doors become almost unbreakable, you have to like find another way in. I'd like to play a bunch of missions, but to like up the doors just to see how bad I am trying to get through a door. All right, let's move on. The next one says, performance goals? This is a question for any devs willing to answer. I was wondering what y'all are doing to optimize your game running on UE4. I remember seeing the early gameplay and seeing some frame rate issues. This is an understandable issue for how early on the game was in development, but I was wondering what we can expect by the time the game ships. Will 60 FPS at 1080p max settings be a reasonable expectation at release? Will 60 FPS at 1080p max settings be a reasonable expectation at release? I have a pretty decent gaming PC, but I had a decent gaming PC when the original Crysis came out, and we all know how that turned out. Good luck to you guys finishing up the game. Looking forward to playing. And the developer replies with, definitely should be able to get 120 FPS at 1080p at least, but I won't comment on this too much until we get closer to the final release. Huh, interesting. Let's move on. The next one says, can we get another AMA from the devs when the gameplay trailer is released? Void Interactive previously did an AMA about 6 months ago here, and he has a link to it right here. I remember this. I actually did a live stream on it. If you want to watch the live stream, it should be at the top right. There's also an edited version of that, but I'll have to sift through all the videos to figure out which one it was if you guys want to watch it. The community's burning questions were answered. I'm sure a lot has changed since then, and the gameplay trailer will not only answer questions, but raise new ones. The devs did say there would be much more information they can provide us after the trailer drops. Why not start off with an AMA? Just a thought. I actually enjoyed that AMA. Shit, if that happens again, I might just stream again. Well, let's see what the developer has to say. I'm sure there will be plenty of questions after the trailer drops, so it's possible we'll sort some things out. Ideally, the trailer will answer most questions, unless those are where is X and Y, but I know for a fact I'm going to sleep for a week the minute that puppy goes live. I imagine working on this type of game would be a nightmare. All right, let's move on. The next one says, suspect sneak attacks? I was thinking about the suspect AI and how one could find something to defend themselves if not arrested. Could they be able to pick up a fellow suspect's unconfiscated gun if said suspect is arrested? If the unarrested suspect's weapon is confiscated? Man, try saying that 3 times fast. Let's see what the developer has to say. Suspects can get up and flee or pick up guns if you don't arrest them. So basically like SWAT 4. Alright, let's move on. The next one says, will we be able to play with the devs? In my mind as a consumer who literally gets to talk to devs every day, I think we should also get to play with them. Will this happen? And the developer replies with, definitely will happen. Yay, I get to play with devs. Oh yeah. The next one's really long. PvP asymmetric balancing? I really wanted to know if separate balancing in PvP is still going to be a thing in RON, considering that this game is attempting a high level of realism. It got me thinking. While the police special forces on one side are organized, have a uniform doctrine engagement, and are limited by laws and regulations, criminals are not. They are more volatile. They could very easily use banned illegal weapons, banned illegal and a greater variety of exotic ammunition, banned combat practices like poison bullets, using performance enhancing drugs on combat that can in addition allow them to sustain lethal damage and still be able to fight back for a short limited amount of time, unorthodox, unpredictable, and dishonorable tactics. Basically anything that would give them an advantage, they would do it. Since the enemies the police forces are going to be facing in PvP are not the same low-life criminal scum as in campaign and co-op, we are talking about criminals that have military or some sort of training and probably even combat experience that the players will have on their hands. In real life, people do not throw themselves in the line of fire for trigger-happy cops. Those criminals can come from many sources, like they can be slaves of debt trained or were already trained and forced to fight, considering that real-life slavery is higher than ever, secretly brought soldiers from North Korea that know nothing else but obeying power, or third world bot African militant combatants, disturbed veterans, etc. To me, this is not a part of realism to be ignored. However, that sounds like a balancing nightmare. Absolute nightmare. Both factions realistically need to have different tools, thus different mechanics at their disposal to engage in combat. While SWAT can have gadgets, etc., the criminals can have some of the tools mentioned above, both having their advantages and disadvantages. I am curious, enlighten me please, what is your take on asymmetrical balancing?
Sorry for my English, not a native speaker.
So those of you that don't know what he's talking about the PvP. In the PvP, you play as either SWAT or paramilitary force.
Here's a picture of what they look like. The SWAT guy is actually the guy that's on the bottom, and the paramilitary guy is the one that's standing on top.
This is kind of like the general look, but I'm sure you'll be able to edit it.
Alright, let's see what the developer has to say. The factions of PvP are SWAT and a rogue organization who have motivations of their own. So ultimately, the balance is symmetrical. Both teams are rewarded more for making arrests. Both teams have similar weapons, albeit with different models in some instances. Going forward, it would be interesting to have an asymmetrical mode, but it's not planned. Later on in the comments, the developer mentions, the rogue organization is focused on capturing these officers for their own means. Ooh. I wonder what the backstory behind this organization is. I can't wait to dig deep into that. Alright, moving on.
The next one says, ready or not status speculation?
I want to start out by saying this is not a message to disrespect or bash the developers in any way. And then he has bullet points. The first one says, the trailer has been delayed 4 to 5+ months past the promised date. The we're recording excuse is being excessively used. It does not take that long to record gameplay. Editing, yes. Perfectionist is sometimes not a good thing. Because of these reasons, I have little to zero hope of this game being available to the consumer. If you're going to promise a trailer by a date, the recording needs to start happening when you promise the date so you have time to edit. As stated before, recording doesn't take that long to do. Does this mean we'll be getting a it's being edited excuse for 2 to 3 months? I'm trying not to rant too much here. To void, being a perfectionist can sometimes be a bad thing. This is one of those cases. You will never make a perfect game. No one will. It simply doesn't and never will exist. I would not want to spend my blood, sweat, and tears trying to perfect every little aspect of my game just to have my community play it and to point out all the flaws and bash it to oblivion. Please, bring it to a playable state and release a beta date shortly after or during the trailer and actually meet the date. Maybe that's why the trailer has been delayed for so long, I don't know. Let the community that is going to be playing your game make the changes and fix your game flaws and bugs. That's what a beta is for. Don't take it personal, but I honestly think that the perfectionist attitude that you have with this is going to be this game's undoing. I would be more than happy to be proven wrong though, just in a more timely manner. If I had to say that there was anything that was this game's undoing, is the fact that they decided to put a date out because everybody was expecting, you know, the trailer to come out on the specific date. But it's very obvious to me that this game wasn't even ready. And they've said in the past that their biggest mistake was to put out a date. That's basically this game's undoing at this point. Like, if the game ever actually does come out, it will still get a lot of people to come and buy it because nobody's making a game that's like this. I just really hope that it's not disappointing if it ever does come out, because all that waiting for nothing would really suck. Down in the comments, somebody says, I fully understand the frustration in this post, but I also know how difficult it can be to record the right type of footage for a cinematic video and then edit it to be appealing. Just making shitty PUBG montages was difficult for me. So adding in a proper showcase of a largely unseen game tied to pre-orders and possible beta soon thereafter, Void has a tough job right now to deliver and make it worth the wait. The person that posted the post replies to this comment saying, I have also done cinematics. It does take a bit to record, but not months. Especially as the developers of the game, with all the tools at their disposal, editing takes the longest and possible voiceovers if it applies. This is a cinematic I did for my armor group. And then he shows a video, I'm guessing, promoting himself. Video is okay, I guess. It doesn't have that many views.
You know, I think the problem with this argument is that he's not the one that's working on a game. Any person could take a bunch of footage and edit it and make it look good within like a day or two, but these guys aren't focused on the trailer. They're focused on making a perfect game, and even if the trailer was to come, they have to make it seem appealing enough to actually buy this product. There's no other chances. Like, the moment that they post that thing, that's what they're presenting. I'm like a brokered record always trying to say this kind of stuff, but it's true. That trailer is the one and only shot, so if it flops, it flops. That's it.
And the developer replies with, have you made cinematics for a game still well in development? Due to this, what happens is we record footage and there might be a few problems that require solving before we can go ahead. No one wants the trailer out more than us, but we haven't been recording it for 6 months. The perfectionist attitude is very important to us, so we're utilizing all the time we can before that's no longer an option. Edit. It's entirely a different beast when you're working off to show gameplay for something that you put years and years of work into. For example, when something does go wrong that didn't before, you feel obligated to fix that, especially if it worked in a previous build, which happens. It's unavoidable.
Yes, I've actually seen the process behind doors with other developers, and I've actually seen these problems happen when they said that it didn't happen in the previous build. And man, that's gotta suck.
Alright, well, that was interesting. Let's move on.
The next one says, is this game still in development or is it already polished?
Is this game still being developed to add features for stuff, or is the main content already finished and you are polishing the game for release, fixing bugs, better optimization, and the developer applies with? All the features are being added, but we've got a while before the final release.
Alright, let's move on.
The next one says, foreign languages? Will there be bilingual AI and or AI that don't speak any English in RON?
In the original SWAT 4, most suspects and civilians speak English with some occasional Spanish thrown in when they're arrested.
Idiota, cita, cigano.
Incapacitated.
Puerto.
Muerto.
Diez aquí.
Or shot.
Madre de Dios.
Lian Yu in Furwa and Park in St. Michael's are exceptions, but the bodyguards in the later missions speak proficient English with some Spanish thrown in even though they're supposed to be Koreans. The chefs in Furwa don't even speak Mandarin Chinese. Koska did speak Ukrainian in the Walcox projects and the sketched off Syndicate expansion, and Bulgarian mobsters and Latino drug dealers who use Spanglish.
Spanglish?
I can never understand how to say that word. Fucking idiot.
Let's see what the developer has to say.
Yeah, there are multiple languages used. For example, we have some suspects and civilians who speak in Russian in a specific level. Somebody replies to that saying, only Russian? Or Russian and English spoken together in that level? And the developer replies with, both. Some of them strictly speak Russian since they weren't born in the States. Others were born there, so it's a mishmash.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, people were wondering when that recent picture got released on Twitter, people were wondering if that was a Russian character, and I was like, where the hell did they get that from? Well, they got that from this post.
I mean, I could see it.
All right, moving on.
The next one says, raw image for Void Interactive on Twitter instead of screenshot.
And he just basically shows off the picture that we've already seen before.
And based on the information that we've seen in the past, I deduce that this person that's sitting right here is actually a AI. And the developer actually confirms this when he says, that's an AI suspect, not a player. So that basically just confirms it. All right, moving on. The next one says, is the dialogue between officers more serious tactically driven in RON? Or is it like SWAT 4 with all cheesy remarks?
I found it odd in SWAT 4 how officers would be cracking jokes at a hospital or nightclub shooting. Kind of off-putting if you ask me. But what about in Ready or Not? I would hope you guys take a more serious approach as we are dealing with gruesome and dark scenarios. These officers are supposed to be highly trained individuals who are focused on getting the mission done as flawlessly as possible, not cracking cheesy one-liners.
And the developer applies with,
gallows humor is a thing. Our officers have wisecracks in there, but they're mostly mission-specific, particularly with some of the more regular levels like a house raid.
Gallows humor? What the hell does that mean?
According to Google, it says, grim and ironic humor in a desperate or hopeless situation.
Oh, fair enough.
All right, moving on.
The next one says, all right, I cut you a deal. You give us the complete weapon list and you don't have to drop the trailer today. And the developer replies with, I can't tell you that yet, but I can tell you that you can kill people with the door ram.
Wouldn't that be funny?
Later on in the comments, he says, currently we only have the classic M14 a la SWAT 3. However, expect more weapons going forward.
All right, moving on.
The next one says, 4-camera replay feature? So I know the replay feature is a speculation for a cool debrief scenario, but if it does happen, it would be cool to have a 4-camera replay. You would be able to see 4 players replay on cameras at the same time. It would be great for the squad to see that awesome breaching scene at the same time to see what everyone else was doing in sync, or some hilarious moments between friends. Thanks, you guys are the best. And the developer replies with, good way of getting 1 FPS and blowing up your GPU.
All right, let's move on.
The next one says, another one bites the dust.
And the post shows a video of a person that basically is someone who doesn't know much about Ready or Not, but chose to make a video on it anyway, claiming that he knows where the Ready or Not release date is. At least that's what it says in the thumbnail, but he never actually talks about that. It's a lot of speculative information. Like, there's no meat on this bone. But to be fair, this is one of those games that doesn't have a lot of information out on the surface. You have to physically dig for it, like I've been doing. I have to dig and find this information behind all this nothingness, basically.
Let's see what the developer has to say.
Good video, and a strong point about people waiting 6 months and only getting a very small snippet. I very much enjoyed this insight from someone who might not be aware of the small amount of interaction we provide with the community via the sub. It's definitely not on everybody's radar that we do this.
No, it is not. A lot of people seem to only look at the YouTube, which is basically where most of their subscriber base is. If you look at their, I think they have 16k now, 17k, somewhere around there, at least as of this video, compared to the Discord, which only has about 3,000 members, and the Reddit that barely only has, I think, 7,000 people that they have in there. But only a select few are still active. We had a conversation about this on one of the podcasts where we said that it will really be best if they actually posted something on their YouTube Because that's like where a majority of their people actually go to watch. I'd like to think that people come to watch over here, but that's just not true. Like, I barely hit like 5k or 10k with these videos, so that's not everybody. Especially if you look at big videos like Jack Frags or GameSpots. Yeah, they're just missing their entire audience. But I'm sure if they release the trailer, everyone and its mother will pick it up, so I don't think it's going to be that big of a deal or that big of a drop-off. All right, well, moving on.
The next one says, how similar will this game play to Escape from Tarkov? A lot of the gameplay mechanics sound quite similar to Escape from Tarkov. I was wondering just how exactly similar the gunplay will be, and the developer replies with, I would say similar to EFT, and hopefully we convey the unique feel well enough with the gameplay trailer. Me telling you how good it is doesn't do much in the way of help. I could say basically anything. Ron possesses some similar systems, but ultimately we're going for a different feeling entirely. Tarkov has really great controls in place, and ultimately they exist to serve a much broader tactical shooter, whereas in the end, Ready or Not is going for a very specific TFPS primarily geared towards close quarters combat. Very interesting.
Yeah, so I've seen some people compare Escape from Tarkov to Ready or Not, and it does have like a lot of features that they've said in the past. One specific one would be the mechanic where if you scroll back on the mouse, you tend to walk a lot slower. That mechanic is going to be in Ready or Not, if I remember correctly. At least I think. It's been a while, so I don't remember.
All right, moving on. The next one says, child auditions? Is there going to be any voice auditions for children? I noticed looking at the voice acting categories, and there doesn't appear to be one. Also, how young are you thinking these kids are? Like middle school age? And the developer replies with, we haven't recorded any children's voices yet, but they'll be in there since there are children in-game. I really hope that the children don't sound as bad as the ones from Metro.
Go away! Leave me alone!
Alright, moving on. The next one says, controller support? I saw in the FAQs, oh my god, someone actually reads it, that controller support is possible, but has there been any confirmation that it will officially be a feature in the game? I'm planning on setting up my PC with my TV, and would like to be able to play on the couch with a controller. And the developer replies with, not 100% certain at this stage, but we're more than likely going to launch with controller support. Somebody replies to that saying, does that include track IR5 and the likes? And the developer replies with, unsure. Definitely a question for Ryro.
I actually have a screenshot of what he said on the Discord about this. At least I think this is the right thing. He says, I use track IR actually. It's not in the current build of Ron, but I have implemented it in the past on our testbed project. Consider it supported for release. Interesting, interesting, interesting. Well, it looks like that's all the time we have for today. I want to thank everybody for coming out to watch. I'm going to try and see if we could do these types of videos at least once a week. If not, then I'll have like an interesting discussion video or a speculation video. I don't know, something Ron. All right, I want to thank everybody for coming out to watch, and I guess I'll catch you in the next one. Bye-bye.